Hello, my dear 6th class students. Welcome back to another video. Today we are going to continue our social studies. I hope you all are doing well, and let's take a little time for study. I think you all are going to your studies. Okay, now we have started the first lesson, isn't it? So what was the name of our first lesson? As I have written here, the name of your first lesson is What, How and When. What, how and when is your first lesson. In the first chapter we learned about what is history. What is history? Everyone, each and every one of us has history, isn't it? So history is actually the incidents which had happened in it can be yesterday, a day before, and a month before, a year before, 100 years before, and 1000 years, or you know, many thousand years before, such as, isn't it? So, what is a history? History is a study of past. Okay. Who are historians? Historians are the people who are studying about the past are known as historian, isn't it? So, why do we study history? When we need to study about the main thing is, why do we study history is to know ourselves and to know the real reason about the incidents which we are hearing. Okay, now let's continue it. Okay, there are, how do we study history? We study history in two parts. One is prehistory and history. Okay, prehistory and history. What is prehistory? Prehistory is a history before, means the history in the time when before the reading and writing are invented. Invented. Okay. History is prehistory and history. History is records of the time when the reading and writing, after the time when reading and writing invented. Okay, now we are going to continue the chapters. Okay, now we have sources of history. Okay, what are the sources of history? See, if we study about yesterday's matter. Okay, if somebody says that in your school yesterday there was a grapes plantation. If you wanted to know about dates, you have to come to the school and know. You will get some of the proofs from there, isn't it? So that is how we can understand that there was a grape plantation here. Okay, now, so such as if you want to study about the past many thousand of years, how can we study? Because we haven't been there in those times. Okay, means any historians are only studying, they were not been in those times. Oh, so how can they understand about them today? So there are sources of those are known as sources of history. So what are the sources would help them to understand about the olden days? Okay, some of the sources given. Mainly two sources are there in your class you have to study. One is archaeological sources, another one is literary sources. Archaeological sources and literary sources. So now today we are going to study about the archaeological sources. Okay, under the topic of archaeological sources, there are monuments are there, then objects are there, then inscription and edicts are there, then coins are there, burial sites are there. Okay, so all this we are going to study under the subtopic of archaeological sources for the study of the history. Okay, so what is archaeology? What is archaeology? Archaeology is the study of past culture, how people live based on materials remain left by the people long ago. That means, what is archaeology? Archaeology is the study of past. Okay, so how people live? Okay, how culture and how people lived in the olden days. So, how can we study about them? So, we study about them by the material which remained by those people. Okay, when you, if you live at home, okay, you may have you may have vessels at home for cooking, you may have bed to sleep, and you may have TVs, so many things, such as so many things may be there at your home. So after many years, if you leave the home and you went to some other places, okay, maybe your generation is passed away. Even though there may be something remaining, something would remain there, like your house. So when somebody enters to your house, there may be vessels, so there may be a pot. So by looking that, you can understand that in those generation, people use things such as. Okay, now archaeology is the study of the past. What is archaeology? Archaeology is the study of the past culture and how people lived in those days by researching material which they remained. Okay, which they left long years back. Okay, who are archaeologists? Archaeologists is the people who, a person who excavate means, if something is, excavate is scoop out of the soil. That means, take out of the soil. If somebody lived in this place for long years back, maybe thousands of years of that, after that, land may be cultivated, or we have built houses here, we have built home here, buildings here. So even now we wanted to study what was here. We just need to dig some of this area. So we can get some of the proof. So some of the old things from here. So that may excavate means take out. Okay, scoop out from the soil, take out from the soil. Okay, so archaeologist is a person who excavates things, older things which people left. Archaeologist excavates these remains, studies them closely. So archaeologist take out all these things, and the one who studies about all these things are known as archaeologists. Okay, archaeologists try to build pictures of what life must have been in the past and help the evidences found. Okay, each archaeologist tell us a story that help us to unravel and mysteries of the past. Archaeological sources help us to help us where no written records are available. Historians also find these sources useful as they help to verify information. Some of these archaeological sources used by historians in the monuments, caves, rocks, shelters, fossils, beds, tools, toys, jewelry, coins, inscription, and pillars, even burial sites, and regarded as archaeological sources. Okay, so what are the archaeological sources? In the archaeological sources, there can be a monument. Monuments, historical monument, can be a monument, it can be a rock, and it can be a pottery, it can be coins, it can be inscriptions, it can be jewelry, anything. Okay, any of these can be archaeological sources. Okay, do you understand what I am saying? Under the sources of history, how can we study history? So we have archaeological sources and literary sources are there. What is archaeological sources? Archaeological sources means, what is archaeology? So before that, we have to understand that what is archaeology. Archaeology is the study of the past past cultures and how people live by the help of the the material remaining which they left years back. Who is archaeologist? Archaeologist is the person who is excavate all these remainings and study about them. Okay, what can be archaeological sources? Archaeological sources can be a pillar, it can be a rock, it can be a writing, it can be a burial site, it can be a coin, object, inscriptions, and index, monuments, anything can be archaeological sources. Now, we are going to study about the first archaeological sources talks about in your class is a monument. Okay, monument. Okay, so what is monument? Monuments is buildings. Okay, old buildings. Among the old buildings, there are some of the name mentioned here. Red Fort in Delhi, the Brihadeshwara Temple, and Taj Mahal. Okay, I hope you have heard about all these things. Okay, so these monuments, buildings, forts, palace, temple, tomb built by the rulers. That means, see about Taj Mahal. All of you must have been heard about the Taj Mahal. Listen, I don't think there may be somebody who did not ever hear about the Taj Mahal. We all have heard about Taj Mahal. So where is Taj Mahal? Taj Mahal is in Agra. Okay. Who built Taj Mahal? Shah Jahan built Taj Mahal. Okay. Even now, Taj Mahal remains a so beautiful place, isn't it? So many tourists coming to there and to visit there. So, Taj Mahal is not a new generation or nowadays building. It's a very old building. Okay, and this building is a historical monument. That means it has a history. It says a history about Shah Jahan the ruler and for the reason why he built this building, and it reminds him, isn't it? So such as Brahadeshwara Temple in Tanjavur is also a historical monument, and Red Fort in Delhi. So these all are the old buildings buildings built by the old people. So these are, when we study about all these, you can get information about the history. Okay, information about the history of the Taj Mahal, you can get information about the history of the Red Fort, you can get information about the Brahadeshwara Temple, so on. So, what is monuments? So, monuments is an historical sources to study about the history. So, what are the monuments? Yeah, Red Fort is a monument, Brahadeshwara Temple is a monument, Taj Mahal is also a monument. In your places, if there may be a temple, maybe there may be mosques, maybe churches, maybe there. So those all maybe can be remained as a monument after a long years. You understand? Maybe your school can be a monument after a long years. Okay. Now, second archaeological resources, object. Object means symbol meaning. I hope you understood the symbol meaning of object. Object includes tools, weapons, pottery, ornaments, paintings, coins that are found during the excavation. So all these are also archaeological sources from the old objects. Like if you get an old plate, okay, all the days people use different type of ornaments, different type of plates. They are not using the same one which we are using nowadays. Okay, so they used an old ones. Okay, so by looking at that, you can understand that all the days people used this one. All the days it was their weapon, and all the days if you get in the early humans, what was their weapon when they went for hunting? Their weapon was stones, sharpened stones, isn't it? So they used sharpened stones as a knife, they used sharpened stones as an arrow, so that was their weapon. So weapons can also say the history. Okay, the weapon which we are using were not there in olden days. Okay, sometimes the weapon which we are using now will not be after 100 years. Okay, they would use another one. Okay, so in object is also an archaeological source. In the object, there can be tools, weapon, pottery. Pottery means, the people who are making different types of vessels by mud, okay, clay. Okay, so that is known as pottery. Then coins, olden days coins. Okay, coins will come to that point. Okay, now, the first one is a monument, second is objects, and third one is inscription and the edicts. So, what is inscription and edicts? So, inscription, another word given is writing and text carved. Writing and the text carved. That means, you can think that so people live in such a condition and such a culture. So, where there be paper and pen? No, there were no paper and pen. So, how did people write? People write with people carved, they did not write, they carved what they have to write in some pillars, sometimes on the stones, sometimes upon buildings. So that was their writing. The writing and inscription means writing and a text which is carved. Carved means, I hope you understood the word, carved means something we write very strongly. That means if you want to write on this board with chalk, you can easily write, isn't it? We can easily write. If there were no chalks, what you would do? You have to take an iron rod. You can, sometimes you can take an iron and you have to give or try very tight, hold it very tightly, and you have to draw like write like a draw. So what is inscription? Inscriptions are refers to the word writing or texting which is carved on the stones and all stones on the wall of temple, caves, palace, copper plates. They provide us valuable information about. So if you go to your page number 15, you can say, you see here something carved on the wall or stone. Okay, so the inscriptions are useful and reliable as they were written during the reign of kings, and most of them are still enact today. That means intact today. That means if I write something on this blackboard with the chalk, we can rub it. Listen. But if you write something or if you carve something on a stone, can you erase it? No, we can't erase it. If you carve something on this wall, you cannot erase it. Okay, so it would remain for years and years, thousands of years. So those carvation of those things are archaeological source. So from that you can sometimes we can find a name. Okay, so that you can understand that this person lived on that time. And sometimes you can find out a picture. So by looking that picture, you can understand, oh, in those days there was this picture. Sometimes there may be that means beautiful portraits. So by looking that, you can understand that, oh, this that was imagination of a people. So however, the inscriptions are very valuable resources and they may not change, and even today some of them are intact. Okay, so the study of inscription is known as epigraphy. So study of inscription are known as epigraphy. Okay, study of inscription are known as epigraphy. Now, edicts. What are edicts? Epigraphy, inscription, and edicts. What is edicts? Edicts is a royal command issued by rulers. Okay, edicts is a royal command issued by rulers. The Ashoka edicts inscribed on the rocks and pillars are helpful historians to construct the history of the Mayurian period. That means all the days royal commandments are engraved on the stones or pillars. Okay. Now, not nowadays, we don't have kings and rulers now among us. So even though when you study about a little bit back about the king's times, we can understand that there were something to write. Okay, so when we are talking about the era with where there no writings are found out. Okay, there were no writings are invented. Okay, no writing and no reading. So in the time of Ashoka, there was edicts. Edicts means a royal commands, a command issued by the rulers. Okay, they issued the commands on the rocks or the pillars. Okay, that would remain for thousands and thousands of the year. Okay, next year, there are coins and burial sites are also there. We will study about them in the next class. I hope you understood all about the archaeological sources. Okay, so let me just recall all what we have learned today. Today's our topic was, our chapter is first chapter. Name of our first chapter is what, how, and when. Okay, so when we study about the history, we need a sources to study. So there are two main sources talking about your classes. Those are archaeological sources and literary sources. Today we just have started with the archaeological sources. What is archaeological sources? Archaeological sources are the material which olden people remember, so known as archaeology. So who is archaeologist? Archaeologist is the person who excavate all these remains and then study about them. Under the archaeological sources, they can be a tool, it can be a coin, it can be object, monuments, burial sites, anything can be an archaeological source. Okay, so under the archaeological sources, we have studied about monuments and archaeological sources because the Brihadeeshwara temple, Ranthambore in Delhi, Taj Mahal are the very huge resources of our generation which help us to study about the past. Okay, then objects. In the archaeological sources, in the object, there can be a tool, weapon, pottery, jewelry, anything. Such as anything, pottery, jewelry, weapons, coins, paintings, all these can be objects will help us to study about the past. And the word inscription and the edicts. What is inscription? Inscription is a writing on the text carved on the sometimes stones, walls, then some other things which are usable for long times. Okay. And another one is royal edicts. It means a royal command issued by the rulers, which is carved on the stones and sometimes on walls. I hope you understood all of this. So go through all the words meaning. If you have textbook, go to your textbook. And if the paragraph which we have studied from this paragraph, if there is any objective questions in your textbook, find out the answers from this part and write it in your farewell book. Okay. I hope you will study and you take time and study. Thank you for watching me. We will meet in the next video. God bless.